Hi, welcome back to this tutorial about drawing a floor plan. This is the part 5. Here I'm going to show you to draw the staircases and then the windows, where I want to teach you another parameter for dynamic blocks. Let's start drawing the staircase located in this room, and all the measurements can be seen here. We will start with the treads on the left side along with the handrail. But before starting, I want to create a new layer for the stairs. I go to the Layer Properties Manager, click here with the right button, then New Layer. I name it Staircase and choose a color for it. Then on the Layers panel, I have to click and change it to the new one, Staircase. Now I can start. The first thing I will draw is a line for the first thread on the left. I type L, press Enter, and as the line is located as 1.3 from the top wall, I go to this endpoint, move slowly down, type 1.3, and then I need a horizontal line of length 1.1. I press Enter, and you see that the line is still white, even I'm drawing in the layer Staircase, a violet color. Although this happened because on the Properties panel, on the color section I have By Block. I click on the tab and change it to By Layer. But you can see that it didn't do nothing, because I have to select the line and then do it again. Nice. Then, with the tool Offset, I'm going to show you a tip to draw all these lines very fast. As I need 8 of these lines with the same spacement between them, there is a fast way with the command Offset. Type O, then type the width of each thread, 0.25. Click on the line, and this time I choose this option, Multiple. I type M and press Enter, and then anytime I click, a new line appears, always with the same length as the previous one. When I have the 8 lines, I can press Enter to exit. After, I want to draw the handrail, but this I leave it for you to make it. Just find the distances in the file. However, this right part, you can leave it a bit longer than half, because after we have to trim it. So, to copy these lines to the other side, it's easy with the command Mirror. Type MI, I select the lines, press Enter, then I have to find this midpoint and draw a vertical mirror line. And choose No to keep the source objects. If you look to the final drawing, you can see this diagonal line crossing the stairs, meaning they continue to the floor above. And because this is schematic, you can draw however you want without any precise dimensions. But let's make it. I can draw a line more or less from here until I reach the wall in the right. For example, here. And then I can get rid of everything above the diagonal line. With the command Trim, I can select all this part. I press Enter. And I can select everything here to trim the segments. Then this part, I have to press Escape to cancel. Select these lines and press Delete. Finally, to draw this small detail here, it's not very important, but meanwhile, I want to show you a new object snap mode. First, I'm going to activate the command line, and as I want to draw the new line starting in this diagonal line, it's a bit hard, as at this moment it only snaps to the midpoint or to the end point. However, if I click in the arrow next to the object snap icon and activate the mode nearest, I can now snap the first point to the diagonal line. But have in mind that this distance will not be accurate. And the snap mode and grid mode, I turn them off, as for now I don't need them. So I'm going to draw three diagonal lines, and the icon nearest makes me sure that I connect them to this line. Finally, with trim, I select these objects and delete these four segments. Okay, this staircase is finished. Ah, not yet. I need a small line here. Now, yes, it is. In the floor plan, there is another compartment of stairs, which are disposed symmetrically in comparison to the first staircase, and the length of each thread is a bit smaller. First, I will copy the staircase to the other compartment, and I want this midpoint to fit in the middle of the horizontal length. And to do that, one process is to draw a line here. I can start drawing, for example, a horizontal line between these two walls. Then, using the midpoint of the new line, I draw a vertical line until the bottom. Then, I can copy the staircase to place it in the new room. I'm going to use the command copy, select everything, press enter, I select the midpoint, then I move horizontally to the right following the polar tracking, as this keeps the same distance to the wall below. Finally, I click in the intersection with this vertical line. I press escape and delete the lines I made only for helping me. Then, to flip the staircase, I can use the command mirror. I select the objects, and for the mirror line, I click in this midpoint. I draw a vertical mirror line, and now it's important. In erase source objects, this time I click in yes to delete the original ones. Okay, it's almost finished. I just have to delete the segments that go out of the room. Remember that this staircase is a bit smaller than the first one. Okay, I will not show you how to do it. You can make by yourself to practice. It's easy. On the next chapter, we are going to insert the windows in the drawing. And if you look to the floor plan, you can see that not all of them have the same size. Basically, here I'm going to draw just one of them, then I convert it to a dynamic block where I will teach you a new parameter to insert. First, if you haven't done it yet, you can create a new layer to place the windows. So let's draw this one with length 0.9 meters. First, I go to the Layers tab and change the layer walls to windows. Then, I'm going to draw a rectangle to make the outline. I click for the first point and I insert the coordinates 0.9, which is the length, press tab and enter 0.08 for the width. After this, with the command line, I make the vertical lines that represent the frame. It's in this grid point, but I should switch off the object snap temporarily. I click, and then the second point is up here. I go to the other side and I do exactly the same. Okay, I press enter and draw the remaining line in the middle. As it's at the distance of 0.04 meters, I know it's in this grid line. I zoom in here and I can click in this point, draw a horizontal line until there. So it's finished. Now I'm going to change the layer to the layer walls for drawing these lines. The line starts 5 cm below the corner and the length is 0.3. I do the same for the other side. Okay, to convert this to a block, I'm going to the layer tab, click in layer 0 because it's recommended to create blocks in this layer. I type B. First, I insert the name and then let's select the objects and the base point. Now, I can convert this to a dynamic block. A fast way is when the block is selected, click with the right button and then in block editor. So with this it's not necessary to select the block. Okay, now I want to insert a parameter that will change the length of the window. The first thing, I need to go to the parameters tab. And this time I click for insert a linear diameter. This is basically a parameter to measure the dimension of the entire window. Hence, the start and the end points are the tops. After, as this by itself doesn't do nothing, I need an action. I click here and the action is going to be a stretch. Then I select the parameter, distance 1. The point to associate with action is this one that makes the length changing. I click there. Then I draw a frame around the area that I want to stretch. And the objects. I will select all these, keeping that line unselected because it will not move from its place. Finally, I save and exit. Then I'm going to the block, I click in it. And here you have the parameter point. It's what I set up before at this moment. If I click in it, you can see all the windows stretching. For example, if I want a new length of 1.35, I type it and it's modified now. I hope this is clear. But if you are not sure how to use the command stretch, click in this card that appears above. It's a quick video about that. Okay, now I guess you have the knowledge to insert all the windows in the floor plan, but I want to show you a couple of tips. For example, I could insert a window one by one in each place, but as I have to modify the length every time it's different, maybe there is a better way to do it. So let's see the case for these windows in this wall. First, you must be aware that they are flipped upside down. This means that we could add a flip parameter to the block, or we can change the direction of the UCS coordinates. I go with the pointer to the UCS, click here, and change it to this wall, for example. Then, I could click in the y-axis and rotate it 180 degrees. And if I insert a block at this moment, is flipped upside down. And I place it here. With this window, I can stretch it to 1.36 and press Enter. And then I can copy this window with the command copy to their places. For the base point, I click in this one, and for the first window, I go to this endpoint, drag it to the left, and type the length of 1.44. I press Enter, and I can place the next window. From this endpoint, I drag left again, and type the next distance between these windows. And I keep doing this until I finish all the windows of 1.35 meters of length. As you see, this tip can be very useful, as I can copy one object to several places without the need of selecting the object again. When I finish, I can change the window that I put outside to 0.9 meters and copy it to the places that has this length. It's simple. Okay, this video is almost finished, but I want to be sure you don't have problems to drop the windows in the diagonal wall. It's again with the UCS coordinates. I'm going to move it to that corner. Click in the X-axis to rotate it. And to move it along this diagonal line, I can click in the other endpoint up there. Then, as I have to invert the X-axis, I click in it again and rotate 180 degrees until you see the green dashed line. Finally, I can insert the window as I did before. It was everything in this video. Thank you very much for watching and hope to see you on the next part of this tutorial, if you enjoyed it, of course. So, see you soon!